back with another segment of our ongoing Yes Cinema appearances. Hopefully this last Christmas won't be the last one. We had a great time, had a great turnout for Christmas night, once again with another threat of bad weather. And it didn't matter. We had maybe even twice as many people as we had last Christmas. So, I mean, are you really going to miss the exit of Matt Smith and the regeneration of the Peter Capaldi? Don't think so. Anyway, we had a terrific night that night, and we have videotape. Yes. And you'll get to see some of the best stuff that happened during the show. So I hope you enjoy it. Let's take a look.
Program you've probably seen about 5 or 6 dozen times already for something very special. Run! Hit it! Didn't get a lot for Christmas. Nothing like I really need. For call the midwives, Benny Hill or Devil A. When I hear that blue box call, right before the silence falls, Santa, please come through. All I want for Christmas is blue. All I want for Christmas is who? our regularly scheduled Much Watch special. Thank you so much. And we'll be back in a little bit with some door prize draws. So hang on to your tickets. Oh, by the way, I'm Mark Dooley of the Hoosier Network, the Indiana Doctor Who Club. Just to let you all know, I'm not just some madman who just ran up here. Thank you so much.
Of Trends Alore is now begun.
Three issues of Doctor Who Insider. The trap. And the winning number is 760-644. There we go. Okay, are you ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's go. Do it and see.
Once there was a planet.
It never works like I wanted to. Thank you.
And unimportant. This planet sent the universe a message. A bell tolling among the stars, ringing out to all the dark corners of creation, and everybody came to see.
Awesome. Thank you for being victim. I mean, volunteering. All right. Well, still wish my horse was here. Well, I tap you on the shoulder. State your name for the public.
Rose.
Rose. All righty. Noah. Bo.
Colton.
Connor.
Dave.
Dave.
Nathaniel.
Nathaniel.
Krista.
Krista.
Kyle.
Kyle.
Eva.
Eva. And Ruth. All right. Well, you look absolutely splendid. We're going to do things a little differently for the costume contest. Last time it was one grand prize winner. But we're going to take this by categories. We're going to do the best doctors to begin with. And the grand prize for that is the first issue of Doctor Who magazine announcing the new series back in 2005. This is a collector's item. People are looking for this.
Yeah, eBay is just chomping at the bit.
All right. And for the best doctor, the winner is Dave. There you go. All right. Now, best child's presentation gets the Dalek Invasion of Earth. Susan's last episode, and it is a tearjerker. So, and the best child presentation is my man here. I'm not sure which doctor you are, but you look splendidly doctorish. Number 11. There we go. Okay. Now, best companion, and it looks like we have several here. Best companion will get The Dominators, which is a fun episode. So, best companion, that's a tough choice. Everybody looks great. So, but I'm going to give that to you, ma'am. There you go. Let's see. Next, for best runner-up on the companions, we have the Doctor Who Loch Ness Monster, and which is the introduction of the Zygons, who just recently made an appearance after more than 35 years. So, and I think we're going to give that one to you. There you go. All right. And we're going to have a runner-up on Doctors, who will get the Android Invasion, which is a great Tom Baker episode. And this is one of the few covers that actually featured the Doctor in the flesh on the cover from the Pinnacle series. And so we're going to give it to the other Dave. There you go. Thank you. All right. And we have an overall prizes for best costumes. Third place is going to get Tomb of the Cybermen with Pat Troughton, the rediscovered four-parter. This is the one they found in a chest in an attic in Tibet, in a monastery. How the heck did it get in there? I would love to be the guy who was told about this, went to the vet, got the chest, it had all kinds of other stuff in it, and found this canister. It says Doctor Who 4X. No telling what was in it. Didn't know. Gets it back to the BBC archive people. They put it in the film projector and go, HUT! One of the best Cybermen episodes ever. So, third place for best overall costume is... Gross. Second place is Series 1 Companion, which was the first of this series of the Doctor Who magazine that does basically covers everything from Season 1 with Christopher Eccleston and Billy Piper. And that one will go to... All right. I might have overstepped a little bit on that one, because we need to have one for the T-shirts. So we will make that the best over, or for the best costume overall. We will do T-shirts. Let's do a T-shirt. There are some cool T-shirts here today. Some who didn't. Just couldn't bring themselves down here to show off. But that's okay. It's okay. We have a recent issue of Doctor Who magazine introducing the man who can't fly a TARDIS. He's going to be fun, don't you know? Life and soul there. Best T-shirt for the day. The Abbey Road. That is awesome. So, all right. Give it up for everybody. And you may all return to your seats because it's story time, kids. Unfortunately, my brother has taken off, so I don't have a real backup for this one. Although, because it would be authentic. There's some magic going on this night that has been buried for a long, long time, for about 40 years or more. that I think was reawakened the day that they built and extended this stretch of Jackson Street. Because back in 1956, this was my home for the first 12 years of my life. This is the building across the street. Used to be, well, of course it was part of the commons, but at that time it was just a stretch of businesses with apartments overhead, large apartments. And it was on the one right across the street that I was raised for the first 12 years. My beginnings as a science fiction fan, as a comic book fan, as an artist, and as just a creator of all kinds of things, began across that street. It was magic, especially at Christmas time when it snowed. the downtown area was the center of commerce. Within 2 blocks, I could get all the comics I wanted, all the monster magazines I wanted, all the toys I wanted, and believe me, I was a spoiled brat. I was like, Grandma, I want this, I want that. All right, anything to shut you up. There we go. There, get him what he wants. So, I began my artistry. Just basically drawing Humpty Dumpties on the walls of my grandmother's apartment, which didn't, and in my brother's kids' books, which did not bring a lot of happiness around except for my grandmother because she saw the talent. But of course my brother, who is not here, can't back this up on me, but it was, oh God, Grandma, he's writing my pokey little puppy again. She said, oh, shut up. When you get a talent like that, you can start griping. Well, he took up the guitar, and now he's far, far exceeded anything I've done. So, but anyway, one of the great things we did in that apartment between my mom's and my grandparents was that we were given a whole lot of stuffed animals, stuffed cartoon characters. I had Beanie and Cecil and Touche Turtle. They were my buddies. We had Yogi Bear, Quick Draw McGraw, Wally Gator, all these great Hanna-Barbera and Disney characters. And what we would do was we'd ask Grandma and Grandpa to get us the biggest cardboard box they could find. Me and my brother would hop into that box, stuff as many of our dolls as we possibly could get in there, and we would pretend it's a spaceship that was bigger on the inside than it was on the outside. And we would go off and have space adventures. Now that can't be a coincidence, because this occurred around 1963. And I just have this feeling there was some sort of magic in that, in on this street and in the air that just kind of tuned me in to what was going on overseas. And it just grew and grew like that. So I am certain that once they rebuilt this stretch of street, that magic came back. And it's here again. And I just love it. And that's why we've all come kind of full circle for these last couple of months with these great episodes of Doctor Who, and just the beauty of science fiction and fantasy. So before I let you go, I would like you all, when you leave here, go find some of that magic for yourself. Just, it may not be here, it may be in other places. Search your childhood, search the good times you've had. And when you find it, who knows? Who? No. We'll meet again. Thank you all.
That was just a great night. I really enjoyed getting together with a lot of people who don't look at you like you grew an eye stalk out of your forehead when you talk about Doctor Who. It's just become that big a thing. And that's just wonderful, because I think it's like the best TV show that's being produced right now. And so we wrap up 2013 with a wonderful time and just about the best Christmas I've had in quite a while. And maybe we'll be back. Yes, we'll be back. So until then, there must be no tears, no regrets, no anxieties. Just go forward in all your beliefs and prove to me that I'm not mistaken in mine. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, everybody. We'll see you next time.
A Happy New Year, everybody. A very Happy New Year.